Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They used to sing a song, "Can't Nobody Do Me Like Jesus," because he's my friend. Amen. Hallelujah. He healed my body and told me to run on. He's my friend. We bless God.
Get any tickets.
Amen. Our scriptural reading tonight will be coming from Deuteronomy 28. Hallelujah. God says there's blessings about to be poured out in this ministry. Hallelujah. Come on, minister, preacher. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. There's a magnitude of blessings that are about to be poured out in this ministry. Some of you are experiencing them already. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. But he said, with the blessings, expect the devil to act up. Expect him to act up. Hallelujah. Because, you know, everything that God is for, the devil is against. Hallelujah. We bless God. Deuteronomy 28. When you have it, acknowledge by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Minister Brooke, Minister Cynthia. Amen. She just walked in the door. We're glad to see her.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
She preached out of her soul Saturday. Yeah. Rip this place up.
Yeah.
Amen. Then we went over to Bishop Melendez Sunday, and Pastor Bowman told the place. Right. My God. Ooh, that man preached Sunday.
Yes,
he preached all night until he got on the floor, started scooting on the floor.
Yeah.
That boy was preaching, man.
Amen.
Yes, sir. We bless God.
Amen.
Amen. One thing he said, and I believe it, he said, any church that does not pray more than 15 minutes is a dying church.
Ooh.
And he's telling the truth. Amen. You have to have a prayer life.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Church has to have a prayer life. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
National Day of Prayer Thursday. We're going to be right here at 12 o'clock.
Amen.
Amen. If you can't make it, if you're at work, wherever you are, just pray.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible said men should always pray and not faint.
Yeah.
Pray without ceasing.
Yes.
Amen. Deuteronomy 28. We're going to do a response reading. I'll read the first verse. Church, read the second. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
All right. Daughter, you ready?
Oh.
I'm talking. I know you're going to talk about Cynthia back there because she just got in here. Amen. Let me know when you're ready.
Which verse?
Sorry, not the first verse.
Oh,
uh-huh. We're going to read down to the eighth verse. Amen.
Amen.
The eighth verse we're going to read together. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And it reads,
no.
And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. Read.
And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Blessed shalt thou be in the city, and blessed shalt thou be in the field. Read.
Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep.
Blessed shall be thy basket and thy stores. Read.
Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when thou goest out.
The Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way, and flee before thee seven ways. Altogether, the Lord shall command the blessings upon thee in the storehouses, and in that thou shalt
lift thy hand.
And he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Give God a hand clap of word of praise for
the
word.
Amen.
I'm just all ahead of myself. I'm so excited.
Amen.
Amen. I'm so excited.
Amen.
Amen. I'm waiting to see what the Lord is about to do in here tonight, because last Tuesday night we had a time in here.
Amen.
We're talking about commitment.
Amen.
Are you committed?
Yeah.
First of all, you blessed. Bless you. You go? Amen. Come on, Dick. Let's pray for you before you leave. Hallelujah. Amen. Everybody point their hands towards thee. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
Lord, we bless you.
Yes.
We give you glory.
Yes.
We ask for traveling mercy. Take him through the airways, God. Let there be nothing that hinders his progress. Bless him to get home, God, and find out that things are as they should be. Bless him to be a light to his family, a light, God, that needs to be shined. Move on his life. Let your glory be revealed. Bring him back home to us, God, safely, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Bless him, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless yourself. Amen. We playing for you. Hallelujah. We're talking about commitment. Amen. Are you committed? Amen. Now there's two ways you can look at being committed. You can be committed to God, or you can be committed in the mental institution. Amen. Because when folks see that you ain't in your right mind, they commit you somewhere where they can take care of you. Amen.
Yes, sir.
You have to be committed, because I was telling the saints when we first came in, God said, I have you either hot or cold.
Yeah.
Lukewarm, I'm going to spew you out of my mouth. Right. That means, God, you're going to make God sick to his stomach because you're not committed. Glory to God. You can't go in Burger King and ask for a waffle with cheese, a Big Mac and expect to get one.
Right.
That's not what they're committed to. They're committed to Whopper. Now they got the angry Whopper.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Whopper so hot you can't even eat. An angry Whopper. I don't want that. Amen. But they're committed to what they do. But if you notice, the restaurants now, they're falling off in sales because they left what they were committed to. They were selling hamburgers. Now they're selling tacos.